All right, I am super excited about this one because I've wanted to do it for quite some time now, and we are going to be making drumbalaya. What is drumbalaya? Drumbalaya is just jambalaya made with freshwater drum that I caught in Lake Winnipeg, and we're gonna get into that right now. One of the best things about jambalaya as a whole is that you can make it all in one pot. It feeds a lot of people if you make a decent batch of it, and it has a ton of amazing flavor. So we have all of these cool ingredients here, lots of aromatics. We've got our Holy Trinity, which is your classic sort of Southern Cajun mix that goes in to start off every single dish. And we've got onions, green pepper, and celery with a little bit of garlic on the side. And a signature flavor that you'd usually find in jambalaya is an andouille sausage. I don't have andouille sausage with me, which is a smoked sausage. I've got a local sausage that I just absolutely love. This is from Miller's Meats here in Winnipeg, and it is a dried Hungarian sausage. You can buy this fresh as well. I really like the flavor profile of the dried stuff, so I'm gonna be adding that in to start off this whole dish. And then from there, we start adding in our ingredients. We need to really develop all those flavors as we go, and the drum is the piece that comes in at the very end. A signature part of jambalaya is that you can add chicken, shellfish, seafood, sausage, a whole bunch of different things, but we're keeping it really simple. We're doing sausage and our freshwater drum. So to kick it off, we're gonna heat up this big old cast iron pan, and everything is gonna be made right in here, and we'll start cooking down our sausage. All right, the pan's hot. I added a little bit of oil, and in goes our sliced Hungarian sausage. Now, I'm not looking to cook these like crazy. I'm just plumping them up slightly and developing a little flavor here. All right, those have plumped up and they're looking crispy, so I'm just gonna slide them out of the pan. And now, this is where the important and fun stuff happens. We are going to start making a roux. So at the low to medium heat, we are just going to add about a half a cup of oil and a half a cup of flour. So we just wanna keep that stirring constantly. Don't get distracted. Don't leave this on its own for any amount of time. And you just wanna stir this down until we get it to a nice sort of milk chocolate color. Stir out any lumps and just keep it moving. So what the roux is gonna do in this situation is it's going to help give you a lot of great texture, but it's also going to give you a very rich flavor. That's sort of a signature taste when you're eating a jambalaya. And be super cautious with any splashing with this or touching it, because this is molten hot. You do not want to get this on your skin. This is going to start to darken very quickly. So keep it stirring and let it get just between that caramel and dark chocolate color, and then you'll be set. All right, color looks good. Now in goes the Trinity. So we are going to toss in our onions, green peppers, and celery right into the roux. And we just want these guys to hang out for just a few minutes. Let them tenderize and sweat out a little bit and bleed their flavors all together, and just keep on developing flavor. We held off on putting our garlic in earlier as well, because garlic burns a lot faster than these other ingredients. So we'll just put our garlic in now too and just stir that around for a few minutes until it's nice and soft. And at this point, I like to reintroduce the sausages as well. So we'll toss those in and just mix them up.
So while the veggies and the sausage are just having a little bit of bath in the roux, I'm going to get my wet ingredients ready. And since this is a rice dish and rice likes to soak up any kind of moisture that it is boiling in, I like to add a lot of flavor at this point. So I've got some chicken stock. I've also got some crushed tomatoes in a can, and I've got a can of beer as well that I'll be putting in there. So I just like to mix it up a little bit. We're adding about 6 cups of liquid here all together. So I'm just gonna balance that out as I go. One of the cool things about this dish as well is that if the rice starts to fluff up while you're cooking it and it looks a little bit dry, you can just keep on adding moisture to it, add more stock, add more tomato, or add more beer, and that'll just keep on giving it a little more life as it cooks. So now that my roux is cooked down right to the point that I need it and everything's looking nice and soft in there, I'm gonna go in with my stock, add the tomato, and hit it with a little bit of beer. Some of those crushed tomatoes.
And last but not least, a refreshing local beer. So we're just gonna stir that till everything's nice and smooth, and then we'll just let this bubble away for about 10 minutes just to cook down that flour a little more further and let this just do its thing. Also at this point, we'll season it with a little bit of salt, some pepper, and our Cajun seasoning. Now after it's cooked for about 10 minutes, give it a little taste and make sure you've got enough salt and pepper in there, and if not, just add it. Now we want to go in with our rice. So we have all of this amazing liquid, tons of delicious flavors in here, and we just need this rice to drink it all up and start thickening this dish. So in goes our rice. Often with a jambalaya, you'll move it to the oven and let it cook under a lid. But since we're doing this all in one pot over the stove, we are just going to stir it and keep an eye on things as that rice continues to soak up that liquid and cook. So we'll just keep an eye on it over the course of the next 20 minutes and stir it every now and then and wait for that rice to swallow up all of those flavors. So the rice is now almost exactly where it needs to be. I gave it a taste. It has still a little bit of a chew to it, but it's starting to fluff up a lot. That pan's getting a lot more full. And now is when I want to go ahead and add the fish. So because drum has a real seafood type of texture to it, it's a little more tight. I like to treat it almost like a scallop. And since scallops are delicious in jambalaya, I'm going to treat it as such. So I'm just gonna cut these drum fillets into slices, almost so that they look like a scallop. And then I'll toss them on top, mix them in just a little bit, and let those cook until they're cooked through. And then we'll be ready to eat. Now, once that fish is cooked through, your jambalaya is done. All we have to do now is plate this up. We want to make sure we have lots of rice. We get as many bits and pieces of sausage as we can. And we also want to make sure that we are getting the star of the dish, a lot of that drum. So let's just fill up this bowl because I'm hungry. Look at that perfect piece of drum. We've got our sausage. And I like to add an obnoxious amount of green onion on mine. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that now. There it is, my very first bowl of jambalaya. I'd be lying to you if I told you that I wasn't tasting this along the way as I went. And it tastes absolutely amazing. There's so much flavor. This is one of my favorite freshwater fish to eat of all time. It just has a great texture and amazing flavor. And I would highly suggest making this recipe. For more information on how to prepare this amazing jambalaya for yourself, go ahead and click the blog post link below. Till next time.